favor because of the money, because of the lack of the current chief of staff.
Do you know why he was serving before he became the chief of staff? You can't get to just somebody just because he is wearing seniority and making. You put somebody who has been in the mill, who has suffered with the soldiers, they knew him, he fought with them and so on. I to tell you the truth, on individual basis, all these chaps they do. Because I don't know them, I forgot them, some of them, I don't know them. It is, because the soldiers, to be effectively led, must be somebody, they know they are lodging, he exposed himself to him. This is...
Beyond
security, SAFIS want to be selected to the government. They want to be other things. Like you said, with the prison, two or three of them are Al-Qaeda and VP. So you said you don't have anything against them. So why not you, as far as on, bring them more together? Make them feel belonging, make them feel like your children.
You better get to this of our civil servant. If you think there are no people from the southeast, there are people from the southeast. But they know they have to go through the mill.
Well,
the best
way was
to not want
the ruling
party. Because when we talk about the regime, what this administration can do is to make sure that APC lasts beyond this administration. And we started the administration from foreign unit to war, to local government, to the state, so that APC will know how many of them there are in state by state, in even local government by local government. So that by the time this administration goes, they will be firmly on the ground and they can continue. And this is the best thing politically for the country and for the party.
So you know, I think when you have one language, people believe that one person is a group.
No, you are being very unfair.
There's
an agreement in APC to move power from north and south, but not parts of the south. Where do you think the president will come from? Looking at this move,
should we allow the party to do that? I just told you that we started from bottom up. And I gave the acting chairman the end of this month, June. He asked for an extension. For them, the committee, we developed terms of referendum, we put a committee, you know, and they are going to give me this report by the end of the month. On the convention we are going to conduct and then arrange the general elections. You know, up to 2003, all the elections. And we started this from bottom upward, so that members of the party will feel they are involved in decision making. Nobody is just sitting here in Lagos and asking them what to do. This is what we are arranging. No, succession planning depends on the party. We are going to give it to the party. The party will sit and make its decision by the constituencies, you know, they want and so on. So those who want to be president, they better agree.
Imagine.
those who want to be president, better join the peace. No, you can never be a president.
It's normal for you to be president.
Even though your administration has given the right signal with regards to ease of doing business, Nigeria has barely improved. And we're losing foreign direct investment to our neighbors such as Ghana. What can we do to make Nigeria a more competitive and more attractive destination for foreign direct investment?
Well, this question was answered. Wonder of this answer. You remember the young people who wanted to march here and remove me? Who they checked that answer. And my answer to that, I got the members of the Executive Council. As you could recall, by the Constitution, there must be a member of the Executive Council from each state. That is the Constitution. Every state must be represented. So I got them. On a Wednesday, I said they should go, each one should go to the state, speak to the governor, speak to the traditional leaders, speak to the business people, and speak to the, especially in terms of that. The federal government, no more vacancy, is full. Go to any state governor and ask him not to give you a contract or to give you a job. You will tell him that no way. The same thing is not a loan. So you may have a will decree, but you may die without having a job. Why? Because nobody is going to invest in an insecure environment. So I told them, I said they should tell the youth that if they want jobs, they will behave themselves. Make sure Nigeria is secure so that people can come and invest. Nigeria is a source for people, know it. We are a rich country. God has endowed us. But nobody can bring, look at the two, today, the 200 buses bought by the former governor of Lagos. Some of these boys went and burned the vehicle. The governor made an hour long thing and I took the album and put it aside. I said, go and tell them to work. Who will go and invest his money in an unstable environment? Nobody will. It's just common sense. So you behave yourself, you make Nigeria secure, and people will invest.
So coming back to the topic, looking at the issue of, yes, we have federal minister, Mr. President, the issue of spending money for subsidies, which is taking money that you have invested in infrastructure, which you also come to. How do we do the subsidy question of petroleum and power?
It's a very difficult question, and I suspect you know it. Nigeria is using their oil, so it can't be too expensive. Nigerian petroleum is being sold from here up to Ghana. At the pump station, Nigeria, people will take, will close the borders. They put jerry cans, they ride machine into the bush. And if you try and give me the cost, and insist that it has to be economic base, Nigeria will say they are old, and they will run and push you out of wherever you are, even if it is a presidential villa. They will push you out. They will say this is their oil. So what we want is to try to get a cooperation of customs, immigration, and this border guard so that it cannot be taken in substantial amount. Customs are doing quite well because we are confiscating tankers, selling the petrol and selling the tankers, and the people who are in disposition of this, they don't complain. They don't talk to anybody, they don't say it. Then the government has taken away their tankers and sold their petrol and so on. We are doing it.
Mr. President, let's talk about debt service to revenue ratio. Under the watch, it has risen from about 40% to 90%, thereabouts. And there are many
people who are paying the taxes
for this heavy debt money.
They're not even talking about the insecurity matter.
Yes, they've been talking before now.
Is your government putting in place to diversify the economy and to further increase revenue.
Well, you spoke of countries on the infrastructure. I would like to check how much we are earning from 1999 to 2004. Our foundation. If you check, you find out that every foundation was $2.1 million. And the average cost of $100 per barrel. So 1999 to 2014, we were earning 2.1 million times 100 each year. Look at the state of the infrastructure. Look at our roads. Look at the rail. Look at power. And tell me which country developed without infrastructure. And you ask those regimes, or that regime, whichever it is, what is it they have given the money? No roads, no rail. I sit here and see the amount of casualties we are getting between Lagos and Ibadan alone on daily basis. Tomorrow I'm going to commission the rail. The road. And ask people who are living in Lagos now going to Ibadan to open the
house. That varies what the problem is. Those ministers.
This is what we have been. But what have they done with all the money they get? Look at the power. There have been a lot of waste. There have been a lot of waste.
There's been a lot of waste.
Yes, yes, I was telling you on infrastructure, the Lord has done quite big on infrastructure. But there is also something about infrastructure that is surprising to me. Yes. You are carrying a lot of this infrastructure to me, to the Nigerian Republic. Road, rail, people are wondering what is the attraction of the Nigerian Republic? Why is there obsession by the barrier towards the Nigerian
Republic? Most of individual and the national rule, you have to cultivate your neighbor. If you don't, you are in trouble. If you go, this is what you have in the Boko Haram. People are not in the good relationship between Niger and Chad and Cameroon. Boko Haram will. I told you about the border between us and Niger. It was a lot of
money.
And Niger, you see. I spoke to one Frenchman, and I have to tell you this. He spoke to us, and I said, you people, in 1885, you sat down with rulers and draw lines. I said, I have first cousins in Niger. There are Kanubis, there are Hausas, there are Fulani in Niger Republic. Just as there are universities in Benin, the whole and so on. You can't absolutely get them off. But the rail, look at the plan, if you read the plan, how we are rehabilitating the rail. Niger, they have discovered oil too, as you know. And we don't want to allow them to go through Benin Republic. We want them to come through Nigeria. We hope they will decide when we take the rail up to Maraki, that they will send all their exports and so on through Nigeria rather than through Benin. Because the railways and the road working, most from Maiduguri to Port Harcourt, Kano, to Lagos and so on.
It is not for the living, not that's what we sound
like. And I believe if you make the infrastructure work, road, rail,
if
you think for that, Nigerians will be very busy. But when the roads are not motorized, the rail is virtually crippled. People have so much time to harass you.
Mr. President, now that you've overcome your health challenges, What is the looking great? What is the outlook for the last 2 years of your presidency? And then in return, after 2023, what do you plan to do? The presidential library, what projects will interest you in retirement?
Thank you very much for thinking that I'm working.
No, we're still bad guy.
I have never abandoned my farm. I still have got a number of cattle. And when I leave, I will be going to my farm daily. I'll try to keep myself busy. Between now and then, I will try to keep on convincing Nigerians that I mean very well. I will make sure that the three identifiable problems we have, security, economy, and political, I will continue to work on it. And as I said, visibly, we made progress in the Northeast, we made progress in the South-South, but I'm overwhelmed almost by Northwest, and they are going to get it very soon.
Mr. President, what will be the dwelling place?
Well, I will allow Nigeria to be discussing. I hope you'll be fair to me. I wouldn't like to say it myself. I would like Nigerians to try and spend time when we came, both economy and security, where we were, where we had been for the 8 years, and try to work. I hope Nigeria will be happy. This is all I need.
All Nigerians will be having fears. What's your message to the people of Nigeria today on your 6th anniversary, on where we are and over the last 2 years? As possible.
Yes, under the system, Nigerians would say what they want.
Yeah.
They want to, their own republic. They don't even talk of the resources, how we can engage ourselves, how we are going to share what we have invested when we are together. How are we going to share it out? How far are we going to meet ourselves? And try and see our population, our young population. If we cut ourselves into pieces, can we win the confidence of investors, real investors, people to come and build factories, employ people, produce goods and services, and then earn from taxation, from employment. I don't like the way Nigerian elite is allowing ignorant or careless people talking all over the place. We have so much to learn and so much to guide together than to try and disorganized people way of thinking that if you become